Dear students, welcome to another class of zoology. Today we are going to learn about the mechanism of breathing. So what is meant by breathing? Breathing is a means by which exchange of gases is maximized. So breathing includes two steps, inhalation and exhalation. Inhalation is also known as inspiration, and exhalation is also known as expiration. So intake of atmosphere gas into lungs is known as inhalation, and expel of carbon dioxide or air out of lungs is known as exhalation or expiration. So the breathing process involves one physical property of gases, that is the pressure. So gases have a property which is known as pressure. So as the gases moves from high pressure to low pressure, so high pressure to low pressure, this is very important, you have to remember, that is air or any gas passes from higher pressure to the area where is the pressure is low. So this is the basic principle involved in breathing. So movement of air into and out of lungs is due to the pressure gradient between lungs and the atmosphere. So this is the basic or key principle involved in breathing. So during the parts of the muscles which are involved in breathing are the muscles of diaphragm and muscles of the ribs. So ribs contains two types of muscles, external and internal intercostal muscles. So these are the muscles extend between the ribs, external and internal intercostal muscles which are extend between the ribs. Muscles of the diaphragm are also known as phrenic muscles. This is very important. So in examinations they may give as phrenic muscles instead of muscles of diaphragm. So have to remember the phrenic muscle. Phrenic muscles are nothing but the muscles of the diaphragm. And also abdominal muscles also helps in a breathing process. So what are the types of muscles which are involved in breathing? So three types of muscles are involved in breathing: muscles of the diaphragm and muscles of the ribs and muscles of the abdomen. So in breathing, two steps are involved. One is the active step, that is inhalation, and another one is the passive step, that is exhalation. Inhalation or inspiration, that is intake of atmospheric air into lungs, is known as inhalation. So as we know that air passes from higher pressure to the lower pressure, so instead of, if the air wants to enter into the lungs, then the pressure inside the lungs must be less than the pressure in the atmospheric air. So to lessen the pulmonary pressure, so the volume should be increased. How the volume of lungs is increased? During inspiration, the muscles of the diaphragm, contract, and also due to the contraction of the diaphragm, phrenic muscles, so the anterior posterior thoracic cavity is increased. This is the anterior, this is the posterior, this is the diaphragm. If the diaphragm is pulled backwards due to the contraction, so the volume, anterior posterior volume, is increased. As the external intercostal muscles of the ribs are contracted, so the ribs and the sternum are raised, they are moved outwards. So this is the outward direction. So outward direction of the arrow shows that the ribs are moving outwards, that is raised. As the ribs and sternum are raised, the volume, thoracic volume, dorsoventrally also increased. Due to the contraction of diaphragm, the thoracic cavity increases anterior posteriorly. due to the contraction of the external intercostal muscles, ribs and the sternum are raised and dorsoventral thoracic cavity is also increased. As the volume of the thoracic cavity increased, the volume of the pulmonary cavity is also increased. As the volume of the lung increased, the pressure is decreased. So the pressure inside the lung will be decreased when compared to the atmospheric pressure. Then the air enters freely into the lung. This is an active process. It involves the ATP energy. So this is known as inspiration or inhalation. Next, after inspiration, the muscles, the diaphragmatic, the phrenic muscles and the external intercostal muscles relax during exhalation. So as the diaphragm is relaxed and it goes upwards, to its original position, and also as the external intercostal muscles relaxed, the ribs and the sternum also comes to original position. So inward arrows, original position. So the volume of the thoracic cavity decreased anterior posteriorly and dorso ventrally. So as a result, the volume of the thoracic cavity decreases. As the volume of thoracic cavity decreases, pulmonary volume is also decreased. As the volume of the lung decreased, pressure is increased. So inside the lung, pressure is increased compared to the atmospheric air. Then the air from the lungs goes outside. So this is the outward direction arrow. So the air from lungs moves out. So that process is known as exhalation. Exhalation is a passive process. So as the diaphragm and external intercostal muscles are relaxed, so the thoracic cavity is decreased. As the thoracic cavity volume is decreased, lung volume is also decreased. As the lung volume decreased, pressure is increased inside the lung. So the air from higher pressure moves to outside where the atmospheric pressure is less than. So this is about the expiration or exhalation. So release of alveolar air to the exterior is known as exhalation or expiration. So it is a passive process. So a healthy human being, he respires 12 to 16 times per minute. So healthy human being breathes 12 to 16 times per minute. Human beings have the capacity to increase expiration and increase the inspirational volume. So pranayama, all of you heard about pranayama. In pranayamas, forced inspiration and forced exhalation occurs. So the forced exhalation or expiration is due to the contraction of internal intercostal muscles and the lateral abdominal muscles. So abdomen also plays a role in breathing. So during pranayama, we forcefully expel the air. So for that, internal intercostal muscles and lateral abdominal muscles play an important role, besides phrenic and external intercostal muscles. So there is a apparatus which is known as spirometer, which is useful to estimate the volume of pulmonary air. So by estimating the volume of air during breathing movements, it is useful to assess the pulmonary functions. If any problem occurs breathing, If a person doesn't take 12 to 16 times breathe, then there is a problem. So to rectify that problem, doctors use spirometer. So this spirometer estimate the volume of air involved in the breathing movements. So it is important. What is the name the instrument which is useful to estimate the volume of air involved in breathing is spirometer. It may be comes in your competitive exams. So very important, spirometer to estimate the volume of air involved in breathing is estimated by an apparatus which is known as spirometer. So this is about breathing mechanism in human being. So in this you have to remember one thing, the pressure, the air moves from higher pressure to the lower pressure. So to increase pulmonary pressure or to decrease pulmonary pressure, so two muscles are involved, phrenic muscles and the external and intercostal muscles. This is about the breathing in human beings. Next, we will meet in another lesson. Until then, happy studying.